In this video, we'll visit the crypt within St. Mary's Cathedral in Sydney, Australia. First up, the crypt would sit on a ley line that was sort of put together by a guy called Bruce Cathy, and he did that via an alternative form of mathematics, and I found out a bit about this via the work of Keith King. That ley line would also perhaps run through the Sydney Masonic Centre also, and a particular fountain in Hyde Park. A cathedral would also have a bit of a kind of little ley line there, sort of, if you will, an alignment with a fountain in the adjacent Hyde Park also. And that fountain indeed would be the well. It would be the same sort of thing as we're going to see in St. Mary's Cathedral itself in the crypt, with the kind of portal way going through that fountain portal there. The crypt is about creation. Just on that subject briefly, you have people like Walter Russell talking about the sort of crystallization, the hardening up of light and so forth. You have researchers like Gariev, who evidently transmitted sort of DNA information via light. So the light actually carried the DNA information. I covered this in my video from 2010 when I made Occult Sydney. So the Earth had dinosaurs on it at one stage, then it throws up, you know, all these other creatures and so forth. We live in a multi-dimensional kind of universe. We're multi-dimensional creatures. Furs Marsh talks about the influence from other planets around us. Of course, we have the influences from the spirit worlds also, perhaps going on here. Many, many things to this. Another aspect here is the dimensions that Peter Malocco has put into the cross itself. It would be 140 feet long by 70 feet wide. It has five large circles in it, and their diameter would be 6 feet. Within the Bible, man was created on the sixth day. 666 is the number of man in the Bible. Perhaps the number of the beast also, blah blah blah, but you also have 555s and 111s and all these numbers continuing, and 888, all this sort of stuff in masonry. So it goes, you know, this is sort of interdimensional stuff, and some of that information I don't have the root of the real information there behind some of that stuff, but we would live in a flickered reality kind of thing. This is like a hologram in a way, and this is sort of described by a shaman friend who sort of talks about the breath of life and this flicker that we're kind of living in a way. And indeed, I would suggest that, yeah, within masonry, they kind of get to the bottom of this with their sort of interdimensional work. But, not the bottom of it, but anyway, you know what I'm saying. So this sort of is carried on through, and there will be sort of inklings to this through this work that this man has done. So let's have a look at it. Okay, folks, I'm in the crypt of St. Mary's Cathedral. Here you can see one of the areas, because there is a cross laid out on the ground. And this one would be 6 feet across, I understand, which would incorporate the number 666. Also within the cross, and we'll move up it, but we have these round circles, of which there are 18 of them in total within the configuration of the mosaic floor here. And there are 18 of those circles, and you get three sixes into 18. We're going to have a look at a bit of the symbology here. It's all around. You can see a reference there perhaps to magic circles and to the four around the one. Indeed, here we of course have the four around the one. We would have a representation here of the element of fire with the red fire triangles around here. And in the center here we would have the Garden of Eden, and you have the serpent there. So it looks very, very much like that. So we're going to move up, and we're going to move quickly due to time. Here we have a reference to Noah's Ark, and very fittingly, beside, and does this say Mars here as well? We would have the planets involved throughout here, as well as the zodiac, and we would have the Pisces configurations here when we're talking about the arc of the zodiac and the rainbow, the spectrum of colours. We'll keep going through very interesting four symbology there. And again here with the serpents going into the center and biting onto the what was perhaps the kind of pineal gland in the center there. Highly interesting symbology, more four around the one there. Keep going through, sign of the covenant here. And further writing here, I'm not quite sure what that says right now. We have the lambs here against the central pillar, interestingly enough, with the lamb at the top. Moving up, more symbology here with the dove of peace and so forth. A ship there, perhaps relating to travel, astral travel. And we will keep moving up. We can see the Masonic floor here, and then on the Masonic floor we can see the kind of ladder there going up, and you can see the angels on the ladder, just as you can see within Masonic symbology also. Mary there talking about water within here, among other things. So we'll just we'll have a bit of a look around at where we are. So we'll keep heading up. And here we have the pelican within the Vesica Pisces, feeding its own blood to its young, a kind of sacrifice. This symbology of the pelican is also upstairs also. And we can see the further dimensional creatures around here also. But with the pelican, there would be an aspect to the pelican within alchemy. So we see the mosaic checkered floor here, and more symbology here. We're not going to get right into it all. Mars again, and I'm not going to read everything. We'll just keep going up. Here we have what looks like a more of an Eastern configuration, but of course pertaining to the same sort of symbology here. Of course, the whole thing here is about creation and so forth. Interesting depiction with the lion right here. We're going to keep moving through. Here we have that ladder again, but instead of the lambs, we now have the birds on the cross here. So we started out, say, on this part of the cross, and we're now moving up. And you can see within the, you can see the energies here pointing into the center. Energies sort of flow into the center. Bit of a difference here, but this would perhaps give us a bit of an idea of the overall scheme here within the within here. So I've pointed out down here, remember, that this one equals fire. So moving up, here we have the tree, making the letter M also, praying against the tree, Virgin Mother, and the bush there on fire, the burning bush, etheric fire. And we'll keep going upwards here. Further symbology of the tree of life here. And just looking over that, and then we get into the center here. As we approach the crossing point, the cross point of the cross, we have the sun depicted and we have the moon depicted. And indeed, we're kind of standing on the earth, looking through this portal way and seeing these two objects. Now, that moon, that it could perhaps also be Venus or even Mercury, but indeed, it's probably the moon as they suggest. And if we look at this here, we can see the plan of the crypt. We started out here with the element of fire. We're going to see further elements. And you can see those circles. There would be 18 in total. We would have the six feet across here, 6 feet across here, 6 feet across here, and possibly here. Let's have a look at an explanation for these. So we have 1, 2, 3, that's 5, 4, and 5. And we'll just go here for a moment.
number one, just in here, the first day of creation, we will see that when we get to the ring of cherubim. We will see number two, which will be the division of dry land from the water. And number two would be up here. Three, the creation of the birds of the air and the fish of the sea. That would be at number three. I'm going to have a bit of a different take on these slightly. And four, we would have the creation of man and woman down here, where we sort of started there, the Garden of Eden, man and woman, so forth. And five here, we have the creation of the sun and moon, which is in the depicted in the center right here. The other thing about in the center there is there is the light of the sun at one side, and then that kind of dark arc, so the light versus the dark also in the center there. So let's keep moving along within the crypt. And it's kind of a portal. You can see how they've sort of a portal in the center here above. We don't have much in the way of detail above, sadly enough, but anyway, we do have the vaults here above, just not a lot of detail. So we'll head this way. And another one of these circles here, you can see the hexagram within there also, the sort of lighthouse, if you will. And again, those four serpents biting, the four elements, the four directions, etc., rather than just the two that is sort of more easily drawn on the caduceus. Now we have the throne of Solomon. And the throne, or the seat of wisdom, you have that program. What was it? Game of Thrones. I didn't see it, but very occult it would be. So, going through here, we now have an outer part to the cross, and the what are we looking for here? Look, we're looking for the elements. So we do have the water here, but the main significance here is to the air, with all the clouds and the birds around here, with the kind of angel up the top here, but the birds and the clouds right around here. And then in contrast to that, we will go across to the other side here. So fire would be up here. We've just seen air, and now if we go over to this side, we will see water. Now it's water right around here, rather than the air of the other one. So now it's water. So we're mostly looking at the element of water, the spirit of water, the elemental spirit, one of the main spirits used within magic practice, I would suggest. So this is another part of the cross. Now we'll head back in. Here is one of these to the Ark of the Covenant. This is one of the 18 to the Ark of the Covenant, and we can see the stars again, Mars, and the commandments within the Ark of the Covenant there. Very interesting. Very interesting. On here we have seven stars within the along the line here. The serpents once again, and another plate here with that dove and the symbology of the light coming forth from that dove, which would perhaps represent the Holy Spirit. We can see the Celtic, so we can see within this configuration here, you know, Eastern and sort of Western, Celtic and Chinese bits and pieces. So we're going to keep going up this way to the top of the cross, so to speak. And here we have the Star of the Sea and the lighthouse and a star up there. And beaming down on a ship
in this case. Of course, the sea may represent the heavens above. Various symbology with the birds here on either side, and a magic circle of fish portrayed here, with the count being 8, and the sort of central point also. Very interesting with the kind of orbs in a way on the outside also. Keep going up, we're still going up, and we see the tree of life once again, and various reference in here. The wheat, the harvest, of the summer harvest, and the kind of bird peacock configuration here, eating of the grapes within the configuration here. And we'll keep going up. Here we can see the gate of heaven, and you can see the two pillars with the portal way going through here, and the two kind of guardians also in this case, and the spirit entities up the top here also. Interesting here with the kind of light and dark, the lamb, and maybe that's kind of a wolf type, sort of duality type plate just here. This hand reaching through, again, the rainbow, two fingers in this case. And then here we have the angels, cherubim, in a prayer fashion around the portal in the center at the top of the cross. So this may well represent the spirit in this configuration. So if this represents the spirit of the pentagram, we have the spirit here. We have earth positioned in the center. We have fire positioned right up here. We have air over this direction. And we have the water over in this direction here.
What I'd like to do now is backtrack a little and take a look at this section that we've already seen of the mosaic floor in the crypt. So to start with, let's do the basic count. We have a 1, that was fire, but anyway, the base chakra. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That would be your basic chakras going up there. You can see the winding Ida and Pingala kind of serpents going up there. And indeed, you can see them here wound up at the base, sort of ready to go up. In a way, up here, Furs Morris kind of describes waves going upwards, etheric waves, if you will. And you can perhaps sort of see that here with this sort of procession going up. It's also kind of tree-like in Fibonacci spiral, or spiral-like in a way too. Many aspects to this. With the birds here, you can see that there's 1 foot here and one foot here. So the bird is kind of stepping up, if you will. And indeed, you can see imagery of this, I would suggest. And within the Sydney Masonic Centre, you can see this kind of 7 steps laid out, which no doubt Masons kind of walk onto and walk up. And there's a bit of a tutorial or whatever regarding the chakras, I would highly suspect in that case. Getting back to the tree here, another aspect, of course, and of course the birds are kind of tied into the symbology of going up the pole and all the rest of it. But you also have this main channel of purple going up through here, and you can see this depicted here with that channel, that kind of pillar, that tube going through the human being also, which is part of this, and it kind of goes to the center of the earth, so forth and so forth. Indeed, in that respect, in the center here, you have that depiction of the portal with the earth here and the sun. With the sun, if you look carefully at the sun, you can see that there are sort of inner sections to that sun, as if you are going through the sun. And indeed, Cirque du Soleil, of all people, kind of portray this entering into the sun, this kind of stargate that is the sun and the planet, sort of, no doubt, also these kind of etheric pathways, if you will. So that's the crown there, the crown of thorns. That would be the crown chakra also. another aspect to this is it's kind of like a tree, and you have these kind of outlying pieces here, and you can kind of see this kind of formation of the tree elsewhere, I would suggest, and within the ancient world also. And of course you would have Jesus Christ in the Christian case kind of situated on the cross, and indeed say, but it's also the tree, and you can also see that within Egypt also, with the tree and the arms anthropomorphization of the tree in a way also. It's all there. The purple color is like an auric field in this case, and indeed within the Bible they put like it's either a scarlet or a purple robe on him, and put a reed in his hand for crying out loud, and all the rest of it, you know, basically make him into the sort of mage figure, the magician figure basically, on the cross, on the tree of life. Indeed, within St. Mary's Cathedral, there is a window above up in the main area. And if we look within that window, we can see Jesus here actually working on his own cross. You can see the red, the male behind Jesus, and you can see Mary over here in the blue, the female. And she has this robe here, this white robe for Jesus in this case. And you can see that Jesus is the carpenter. He's basically the mason in a way, and he's doing some work here in the physical, and he's actually making a hole, a portal way in the center of that crossroads right there. So that's it, and he's sort of making that right there, sort of in the physical, if you will. Now, you also have this sort of tree here also. Another thing is that you have the kind of black squares on here and the white squares, so the black and white squares on the floor here, the kind of black and white floor, if you will, the black and white checkered floor. Here we have Jesus making this cross here, and indeed within the church elsewhere you can see crosses of light. And really, this is what this is really all about. This is interdimensional stuff. And with the Bible, you can read it on the sort of physical level, but then also you have the level of light as well. And really, the physical level of the Bible is really perhaps for that kind of literal understanding for people up to 12 years old. That is perhaps the case. And then after that, people should be, sort of starting to learn the deeper meanings behind books like the Bible. Getting back to the floor here, to this initial design, we have another, so we have the tree here, and indeed, Jesus has that cross in the window that we've just seen, made out of kind of logs, if you will, and you can see other descriptions of this. In a way, it's all kind of organic wood foliage, if you will. And there is a first-class relic within the St. Mary's Cathedral, and if you look closely at this first-class relic, you can see the pillar of foliage in the center, and you can see angels tending to that pillar. They are perhaps sort of crafting the light that is that pillar in a way. And indeed, if you look carefully at other angels, you can see that they are kind of emerging perhaps with the leaf from that pillar also. And indeed, you can kind of see that kind of merging out of the tree within Egypt and so forth, this kind of morphization. That pillar of foliage can also be seen within royalty and elsewhere. It can be seen on the checkered floor within on the mortar album cover. And this would perhaps be an etheric formation, perhaps reminding one of Jack and the beanstalk in the way. And of course, Jack would be Jacob, Jacob's ladder, and Jack and the beanstalk. Jack is a widow's son, and of course, Mason's a widow's son. All this sort of stuff sort of goes around itself and ties in, basically. Within the cross here, you can see within the center, you can see the kind of joining, the union, the kind of union jack, if you will. And indeed, above this, you kind of have that union jack configuration also in the vaults above. But you have, like, say, earth, air, fire, and water, the four directions, four seasons, all of these energies kind of coming in, these elemental spirits kind of coming in, converging on the center and making for this portal way, this well, the sun well in the center here. In the case of the four elements, here we have the eight, so you would have the kind of in-betweens with the four elements. That would be the alchemical in-betweens of, say, hot and cold and dry and moist, etc., or wet, these kind of alchemical in-betweens, or in directions southwest and all that sort of stuff. So that's this kind of the magical portal way in the center here. The green area around here, now I would deeply suspect that that particular region would relate to the aura here. So you have the kind of line of chakras through here, and then you have the aura, and that would be that auric field around there. And this part here would relate to the earth in part, and it perhaps sort of a representation on the earth here, the earth connection to the human body, to the human form. In this case, with this auric field here. So you have these various aspects in here, and of course you have the elements, you know, with fire depicted, air and water, earth, although earth is perhaps here, but with the spirit in the center it usually is. But here, over the International Eucharist Congress they had for 2012 in Dublin, this is the Catholic event, they have the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The seven chakras going up here, and you would have the, this would be the head and the arms here. This is a magic circle with the spirit in the center. All of these participants in the magic circle here would be imbued with one of the elementals, and I've been through that plenty of times before, but you would perhaps have this sort of same configuration here in a way you can sort of read into it that way also. So we'll move on back into the crypt on the journey. So we'll keep looking through here, and here is another plate with the term charity. We can see that on the outside of this church also, that reference, and we have the kind of mage in the middle of the cross here in a way. If we look over to this side, we see the four circles, the four around the one. And over here we see a further symbology. We'll just have a look at that quickly. And here you can see the two fish there. What else can we see? There is a bit of a, within this kind of altar up the front here, there is kind of an interesting tent situation there with something in the center, which is really interesting. Kind of magic ritual kind of configuration perhaps. Notice the square positioned within there also. And within the center here we have what looks to be an interdimensional creature positioned atop here, a dragon it looks like. And the tassels also, that perhaps pertain to the scales also. And on this one, you have the tree with that shield with the three pillars, showing the middle pillar with that tree in the center. The two outer pillars would perhaps refer to the energies of male, female, fire and water, etc., with that kind of meet-up point, that cross in the center. We have the three pillars here, 1, 2, 3 also. And we'll just zoom in on the grail, represented as the central pillar also within the center here. Just try and get a shot of that. So we have the blue and the red with the veils here, the meeting of male and female, red and blue, and the interdimensional spirits. You can see the halos there. This is the within the. This is like a magic ritual situation using the elemental spirits shown through here. Here you have the altar, and it's interesting, kind of. Anyway, this is kind of like an altar in the center, but it's hollow, with the Garden of Life kind of coming through that center pillar, with the magic circle around it. You can see them kind of looking upwards, as you can see, masons looking up also.
really interesting configuration. So I've got limited time, so let's keep rolling through here. Luckily, I've got the place to myself. There are various displays on because it's quite close to Christmas time, but this cross here shows Jesus the mage with that green see-through veil, and he is in the midst of the red and the blue with the chakras, with the crown chakra lit up in this case. And you can see what looks to be the phoenix rising within this as well. It's all alchemy. And on here, if we look down at this book, we can see the bookmarks represent the blue water, red fire, green earth, and the yellow would of course represent air. Another reference to the four elements, I would suggest, within the church here for people, you know, who are kind of used to this symbology. Looking at this cross here, there's that tree with that light sort of above the tree. And yeah, just some various detail there. The throne here with the two chairs to either side. You can see this configuration within masonry too. We will keep going through here. I want to keep moving. Interesting picture here to have here with the pyramids. But these are temporary pictures here. And we'll have a look at some various items here and there. We have a grail just here. Archpriest John Theory. And here we have a key, gold key, and the priest's mitre hat. Like a staff there, the trowel, and implements in the square that you will see within masonry just here. The mitre and the mitre box just here. Various medals and stuff. We will keep going through. Really interesting depiction here of the Black Madonna with these, with this progression going up. And yes, very interesting. I do need to keep going. Here's a crozier here, the priest's staff crozier. The prayer beads book, really interesting here with this mitre. And if you look at the detail, you can see the foliage sort of going through that loop, through that sort of hoop, if you will. This is represented over and over and over again. There are some tombs. There's the four around the one here. There are some tombs in here and bits and pieces. Here are some confessional boxes, rather sort of creepy in a way. And the organ here to add to the vibration of the place. Now, here we have these miniatures, and indeed you can see pictures of priests holding miniature churches and angels, etc. too. And I find this quite fascinating. And of course, Furs Morris talks about the angels, about these being about architecture being a representation of light, and that there are building angels and so forth. There also seems to be a tie between King Solomon, the jinn, and Solomon's temple. And these would be churches of Australia. So there are different churches represented within here. So there we are, we're back down near where we started. We'll now just skip around this way. Various displays, and I'm getting through here very quickly. This is an interesting display here, with the red veil pillars and so forth. the priests among the pillars within here. Very interesting. And then I just want to come over here and notice on the ceiling here all the fire representation and water representation, with the meeting of fire and water in the center, which I find extremely interesting. The flower of light here, and another one here showing the light of the flower, and in a way the sort of magic circles up here too, configurations. Find this very interesting. The three pillars with the sort of S in the center, and the mage here, and also the castle in the center, that central pillar in the center. And yes, lots of really interesting symbology within the crypt area of the St. Mary's Cathedral here in Sydney. Within the window configuration here, you have what would perhaps be Mary with the zodiac sort of represented around, and it's possibly a representation of the sun in part, the spirit of the sun in part, the crown crown chakra there at the head with the zodiac around. Up here we can see the priest carrying the orb, a spirit orb, the crown, the light going through the crown, heading down sort of that way. Within the configuration here, the architecture with the two pillars and the portal, and you can see the light coming kind of out of the portal if you look around there. Very interesting how architecture gets is involved in the symbology.
Okay folks, I hope you've enjoyed this tour through the crypt. The baptismal font comes to mind with the flowing four rivers coming from it, and in a way, you know, perhaps interdimensional forms and so forth. Just very interesting. I hope you can see that within the church here, they are representing, and elsewhere, they're representing the physical and non-physical. And there is a massive disconnect between the general public of perhaps the earth, really, and this concept. It's just incredible. So anyway, bye for now.